outside of the Lastenbell Gate, and there's a scene waiting for us somewhere around here.
Saray, look! Alicia and Lucas!
As a messenger of the Kingdom of Highland, I am here to discuss terms of a truce. I would like to meet with a representative of the Roland's Imperial Army.
We honestly wish we could allow you to pass, but Highland and Roland's are still officially at war.
This is a decision that has to be made at the top. I'm afraid as mere rank and file,
Alicia! Lucas!
Saray!
I knew you were alive!
You're meeting with Roland's?
I hope. It seemed like this might be the last chance for diplomacy.
A Highland princess wandering all the way here with no escort?
Lucas?
You're a trooper.
What do you mean? She's got the best guard in the world.
If there's a chance we can stop the war, it's a small price to pay. But we're running into some, jurisdictional issues.
Shepard?
You're with the Platinum Knights, right? Do you think you could contact Sergei for us? Tell him that Saray's friend, Alicia, has come to visit.
If it's a meeting between friends, then the Knights have no need to interfere.
I'm sorry my subordinates couldn't be more flexible with you.
Not their fault. I hear they work under a very rigid captain.
You caught me there. So you're Alicia. I am Sergei, a friend of Saray. Well met.
I'm Alicia. My sincere thanks for helping us the other day.
Not at all. Would you like to join me for some tea?
Certainly. I'm thankful for this opportunity.
We won't let it go to waste.
Damn peaceniks. Putting good mercenaries out of jobs.
No kidding.
This calls for booze. What do you say, Shepard?
Poor Lucas. He'll have to become a baker. So, where are we going? Go to the sanctuary to check on Alicia and Sarah.
All right, that should do it for now.
Yes, thank you for all your help.
Aw, it's over already?
The first meet and greet, I've received an invitation to Pendrago Castle.
By yourself?
In exchange, His Imperial Majesty of Roland's will allow me to meet for direct negotiations. Not bad for a bottom-rung princess, huh?
We are comrades who battled the dragon together. The Empire will have the decency to acknowledge that.
Neat. Guess the peace talks are in good hands.
And here I thought the war would be dragging on and on.
Oh no, that was a pretty good one! I'm jealous.
Is it a competition?
If it is, then shoot me.
Saray, would you be interested in coming to Pendrago with us? You're a key figure in bringing our two nations together.
Thanks. But that's a dream that you should be the one to fulfill.
I suppose. Best to you on your journey.
You too, Alicia. Sergei.
Not to mention our plastered buddy out there.
I should check down Lucas first. They did the close-up on Alicia's chest. I thought she had something in her hand. I don't know if that was just a fan service angle or what exactly. Oh. Wrong way. uses the wind steps at full charge, so shouldn't be too bad to cross the town. Although the frame rate's taking a bit of a detour time. No, not that way. I want the herb. Saffron. I need to start using those.
I hear they're actually making progress with the peace talks. That Princess Alicia is a godsend.
She sure is. If only a certain layabout would follow her example.
My doggie's happy too. She hates war.
You and me both, puppy. You and me both. Hey, bud. You up for a drink?
Anything to get out of this armor.
So let it be known, alcohol is the
eternal equalizer. Our departure can wait a day.
Huh? But...
So sleepy all of a sudden.
Yeah, the frame rate's dropping.
Oh, my back! I gotta lie down.
Get us a nice room.
Come on.
Yes, yes, it is very noticeable.
Thanks, Lila, for hanging out with me.
Don't mention it. I was thinking of coming up here and watching the city anyway.
Was gonna make a chaperone joke.
So this is where Saray's guidance has led us.
Indeed. I'm sure he is doing much the same, watching them and thinking about how far we've come. Edna and Zavid too. After our long journey with the Shepherd, I imagine they're using this time to reflect on their past and, perhaps, their future.
Kinda like us, huh?
Well, Edna coming to see me? Should I be scanning the skies for pigs?
I want you to tell me, why were you killing Hellions?
Where'd this come from? Why now?
Is it to save them? Did you make up your mind that it's something you have to do in order to save them, like Saray did?
Oh, I get it. You still haven't quite wrapped your head around the idea of death as a form of salvation. And so every time you put it into words, it's been to convince yourself.
Is a smart woman. I imagine right now she's busy sorting out her feelings before we face our final battle. No doubt she's consulting Zavid for guidance. He's seen more of the world than any of us, the good and the bad.
You're really a good study of people. You should have been a school teacher.
Oh, but Rose, you had something you wanted to ask me, didn't you?
When the dragon appeared, Saray found his answer right then and there, didn't he? It was that he didn't want that battlefield to see any further killing or bloodshed.
Yes. And then he immediately took the actions he deemed necessary in order to achieve that. Time flows differently for people with a vision, or so it seems to the rest of us sometimes.
is incredible.
Wow, look at all those stars. Yeah. I forget who said it, that there are as many emotions as stars in the sky. I can totally see that.
A metaphor for how each emotion sparkles in its own way, huh? Must have been a romantic who came up with that one.
But you can also sense his insecurities about that, can't you, Rose? Like he's constantly on edge, worrying that if he let his guard down even a little bit, he'd lose his way again.
I think Saray himself might be the only one who doesn't see that. I mean, you know how little it takes for a taut string to go snap, right?
Are you worried?
Not worried, really. Whatever happens, whatever the future brings, I hope I can make it work somehow. No, I know I can.
So that's your answer.
I guess so. But I've always been like this, ever since I was a kid.
I'm starting to understand why you don't generate any malevolence.
Everyone not to worry, and to just go do what they need to do. Pow! But I don't mean like, see ya, have fun, I'll be over here. I promise I'm with the rest of you guys for the long haul.
Don't you think it would be better to tell that to everyone, not just me? After all, I'm sure Edna and Zavid would take no small amount of inspiration from it.
It'd be weird to walk up to them and be like, I am here! We are friends!
Probably true.
Sheesh, you women folks sure are complicated. But then, that's part of the appeal.
Are you just stupid?
That was totally a Zellos line.
Yep, big old stupid, Ed. The type who can't do anything but believe in the one way he's found to get stuff done.
What makes you believe in it?
I just have a need to protect the pride of my friends and fellow Seraphim. No one becomes a Hellion because they want to. But when you turn into one, you know what that means, right? So that's why I end it for them, for the sake of their pride.
And you think that saves them?
Who knows? That's something they get to ponder after death, in their own personal afterlife.
Huh. How gallant of you. So that must be what makes you so...
attractive?
Ow! Hey!
Knock it off! Don't you all have one more thing you need to brace yourselves for?
It'll depend on what Saray does with Maltellus after we take down Helvoth. But you know what? That's all right. I'm prepared. No matter what he decides, I'm willing to accept it.
Gotta say, I think your resolve wins out over mine. I don't even know if I could do that. Just look on silently while one of our own suffers in agony.
Well, I wouldn't worry too much about that. We're all in this together till the very end.
So, if Zavid's quivering in fear, you'll be there to give him a gentle hug, right?
Gross.
Well, if my saying something is enough to cheer those two up, it might be worth it after all.
It's enough to have someone to lend you a kind word. After all, that's what friends and comrades are for. But Rose, if you don't mind, may I ask what prompted you to bring all this up?
I just kind of thought you and I might have sort of been thinking about stuff along the same lines. I just wanted to tell you, you don't have to carry it all by yourself. Huh? What? Did I say something funny? The two of us really are more alike than we realize. We commit to things. We decide on what role we're gonna play without really consulting with anyone else. Oh, now that you mention it... So that's why I felt like we might be sharing the same thoughts. We're the same, independent women. Rose, I must thank you. I feel like a great load has been taken off my mind. Really? Hey, cool beans! I'm profoundly grateful to whatever twist of fate brought us together. You really are a drama queen, Lila. Aw, Rose! Alright, come on. We got some friends to go cheer up.
There's something I learned from this journey. Some stars you can't see. And because you can't see them, you think they're not shining. But they are.
It turned out that there were a lot of stars that we couldn't see from our home in Elysia.
Once people notice the stars, they start to understand just how brilliantly they shine. Just like how Alicia finally got a sense of what Seraphim were truly like the first time she heard your voices.
That was a trip. You should have seen your face.
I was really excited back then. It gave me hope that one day other humans might be able to talk to the Seraphim.
But even then, you had to cut off your senses and hold your... Oh, I see. You were actually contemplating what you'll do after the last battle.
Yeah. If I let myself become a vessel for Mautelus, and shut off all my senses, we might be able to spread that power throughout the entire continent of Glenwood. If it works, and that's a big if, the Squire ought to be able to wield power like mine, even if she doesn't possess natural ability on par with a shepherd.
So long as you entrusted all of your senses to the Squire, it's not out of the question. And we might be able to grow the ranks of squires who could help us. Just think of Alicia. It's arguably a more constructive approach than just waiting for another shepherd to appear.
Exactly.
But you understand the implications, don't you?
Yeah. Until the squires can quell enough of the Earth's malevolence to let Mautelus' natural purification take over, I would need to wait and sleep.
By bonding with Mautelus, you'll be abandoned in time. It could take years. It could take centuries. And even if humans appear who can see and talk to Seraphim, there's no guarantee they'll choose the path of coexistence.
I believe in them.
What about your dream? Weren't you going to go off exploring ruins around the world?
My dream will live on, so long as I don't forget.
Very well.
Thank you, Miklio.
You're like Proto
typically stupid.
It's not so much that guys are stupid. It's just that the ladies are too smart.
What's that, your philosophy?
Huh. Looks like the gang's all here.
I suppose you were all listening to us then?
Yes.
I may not be Edna, but you really are...
Totally.
Stupid.
Let's head out.
Huh? We're not waiting till morning?
No farewells to Alicia or anyone?
I'd like to set out under these stars tonight. So that every time I gaze up at the night sky, I can remember this very day.
Guess we've got our own romantic right here.
You think so?
So what's up? Are we going?
Yeah.
To the last battle.
Yeah.
All right then. No doubts, no regrets.
Here unlocked. Head to Elysia in search of Camelon. I hope we can warp, because that's a long walk.
You're not worried about Alicia and the others?
Not at all. Sergei and Lucas are with her.
Our next destination is Elysia.
Yeah. There should be a passage that leads to Camelon where Maltellus is waiting.
What are we gonna tell Gramps?
Let's just not tell him.
Saray.
There's no need. It's not like we'll never see him again.
You're right. Let's do this.
Okay. Okay, so we are now in the basin. I went ahead to check out what this dungeon was. The remains of Melchior. So I think it's supposed to be Melchior as in the wise man, but maybe mistranslated. Anyway, there was a super hellion that I passed on the way here that we're going back. So if you run past these guys, that's him over there. The big sword and the smoke. So, Dragon Warlock, level 62, resists damn near everything. Decent HP.
Thing's freaky strong!
A Dragon Warlock Hellion! Seraphim who succumbed to resentment turn into this type of Hellion. Deep resentment?
Let's do this later! We gotta focus or we'll get crushed!
Tiger Blade!
This might be bad.
Yeah.
wanted to Mystigar.
Ocean Blast! Shoot off!
Get out your hand! Break down! Break on through!
We're survivors, no matter the odds.
So yeah, the reward there kind of sucked. No EXP for Edna. Anomalous Orb, various other crap.
Phew. It might not have been as strong as a dragon, but you could have fooled me.
A dragon?
Something bothering you?
Yeah, I guess. It felt like that Hellion resented us somehow.
Really?
Just a gut feeling.
Huh. I wonder.
Hellions are just like that. It's purified now, wherever it is. It's probably feeling great.
I hope so.
Could this be some sort of training?
So we're going into the Melchior Ruins. But I'm a bit surprised they mistranslated this so badly. The person doing it must not have been familiar with who Melchior was.
Why don't we take a rest and eat some snacks?
Let's see what we have over here.
What's this?
A lot of gold, more caskets. Never found the meaning of the one in the frozen overflows, Trisol's cave, whatever.
My instincts tell me that there's treasures nearby.
Hypervelocity boots.
Is that an herb?
I need to fight real quick. Wait a second, I didn't actually go into that one.
Is that a treasure chest?
Gold. Flabran. Yeah, those things definitely aren't the hassle you had to go through to get the freaking key. This way first. Nothing. Okay, it appears I made a poor choice. The other area was much simpler than this.
I sense treasure nearby.
Grape shell? All divide.
Found this.
Okay, I had to walk away for a minute, but I think I know where I'm at. So this time I want to take the northern route. Lots of guys on the same end. see if this unlocks other regions for me to explore in here. Oh, that doesn't lead me to that one place. That's interesting. I want to keep my wits if I have to fight whatever's in here.
What's this? Instincts tell me that there's treasures nearby.
Photonic ray. The other thing is I wanted to make sure that there wasn't anything in here. Such as... Norma, that's what they're called. Water attack power. Is this good for something like Miklios? On the one he's using. Because let's face it, this one's in a really convenient spot. Oh yeah, so I also got some new gel, I think. Increases allies' max HP by 30% when in battle. So we're gonna go down a floor, then come back up over there, it looks like. Unfortunately, due to the way that light bar is set up, it's hard to see the actual portion.
Tell me, how does love make you two feel?
I feel like I want this jerk to get away from me. Is that love?
Oh, yeah. That's love for sure.
Love takes many forms. I see. Remove the ego from a love-hate relationship and what's left.
Ouch.
I could use something to eat.
Is that a treasure chest?
Monocle. So, hopefully it goes without saying who this one is meant for. Oh, come on. So stupid.
Nearby.
For gold? Gooey stuff.
What's this?
And gold. Don't really care to do the fight over again, just to show what it's like when you actually know what you're expecting.
Yeah, I don't feel Gramps' blessed domain.
Did something happen in Elysia?
You guys, let's hurry!
Yeah!
So much malevolence, it's stifling.
I've never seen the Aroundite Forest in such a state.
I can smell herbs nearby.
Seems like most of the enemies here are weak to Edna, so... I'm gonna swap her in.
My instincts tell me that there's treasures nearby.
Souffle. Super Hellion from the look of it. Yeah, I think I may want this one out of here. Luckily the penetrate ability actually isn't really that good. If you could put it on like a... piece of armor or something like that, that would be better. But the current form is not very impressive. And what's that? Some sort of new werewolf type. Chamomile. So I think that was actually number 15. No, it's just 14. This place might turn into a mess. If you want to do some grinding, this is definitely the place to do it, as long as you have a decently skilled Edna.
Is that a treasure chest?
An elixir. Not all those are golems, apparently.
That smell! Is it herbs? I sense treasure nearby!
Well, we're starting to find a lot of topaz stuff. Be able to fuse something worthwhile. And I have to fight him out. Don't I? No, I did not.
Is that an herb?
People!
More like corpses. Looks like they were soldiers from Highland.
So the humans came to invade Elysia.
Someone who could wield their powers even within Zenris's domain must have led humans and Hellions into this place.
Heldolf!
Maybe he was trying to get the humans to destroy the seal so he could get to Camlann.
I don't know about that. Remember, he's linked up with Mautellus. He could probably cut through that seal like butter.
Yeah. No doubt Heldolf is already camped out at Camlann, waiting for us. This is likely just his way of tormenting me.
Well then, if we waste any more time here, we're just falling into his trap.
Then let's press on to Elysia.
Pretty obvious what Kittybeard is after.
Yes, corrupting Saray with malevolence, I take it.
Saray's aware of it. You can tell he's trying his best to keep it together, despite the circumstances.
Ugh! Screw you, Smeldolf! No one can keep their head on straight when their friends and family are in mortal danger!
Who knows what evils he may be plotting in order to cause Saray further heartache?
I can hazard a few guesses. We gotta stop him, no matter what!
Let's go.
What's this?
Life bottle? herbs or anything. Nothing there. And I was hoping to at least get to the gate. Just to... Whoa. Well, that'll be the perfect note to end this video, I think. So let's save.
Darn it!
A powerful Hellion like this right at Alicia's gate!
Saray!
Yeah! Check this one out!
Cerberus, but it only has two. Well, maybe there's a third head on back. So this would be an Cerberus. Which one is it that he's Earth? They jipped me out of 12th grade because the fucker healed and then blew away Rose. Nickel and dimey. Luckily that was enough to get this guy to level up. Thing is, he's still really, really far behind. I don't really have much desire to try to bring him up to speed. But anyway, I'm going to put the break here. We've arrived at Elysia, and we'll find out the damage dealt in the next video. Until then, I'm the Hero of Light. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.